Well, happy December, everyone. Kicking off the holiday season, I watched 2015's The Night Before, starring Joseph Gordon-Levitt, Seth Rogen, and Anthony Mackie, and I had a hell of a time. Last night, to put myself in the Christmas spirit, I decided to watch The Night Before. Now, I've watched this once or twice over the years, but it's always just as much fun each time. The story follows three longtime friends who have spent every Christmas Eve together since Ethan, played by JGL, tragically lost his parents in a car accident about 15 years earlier. At some point, the tradition began to surround trying to get them into an extremely exclusive party called the Nutcracker Ball. Now, in 2015, although Ethan has pretty much stagnated in life, Seth Rogen's character, Isaac, is now having a baby, and Anthony Mackie's character has become a successful athlete. So they've decided that this will be the last year for their wild Christmas Eve party, and fortunately, Ethan has gotten a hold of three tickets to the ball. To start off, our three leads seem like they've legitimately been friends forever. This movie was written and directed by Jonathan Levine, who also worked with JGL and Seth Rogen on 50-50. So we know that they've all built some great chemistry together already, but Mackie fit right in there. They have a lot of fun together, but when things get serious, you can really feel the love they have for one another. Now, none of these three really break new ground with the type of character they're playing, but they all do a pretty great job. JGL is charming and lovable as an emotionally stunted slacker. Seth Rogen goes on a pretty intense drug bender, which lets him be funny and loud and nervous, like we like to see Seth Rogen. And Anthony Mackie plays a cocky rising star. Like I said, no major performances, but each one of them gets multiple laughs, and you can tell they're having a good time playing the character. But beyond our leads, the supporting cast is insane. Jillian Bell plays Rogan's wife, Lizzie Kaplan plays Joseph Gordon-Levitt's recent ex, Ilana Glazer plays basically a real-life Grinch, and most importantly, in a very strange genre switch, Michael Shannon plays a wise and incredibly calming drug dealer named Mr. Green. Now, Michael Shannon is so subtle and understated in every scene that he's in, but he brings a hell of a lot of weight to a character that could have just been a one-note stereotype. Legitimately, Michael Shannon might be the best part of this movie. With cameos, or at least smaller parts, from Mindy Kaling, Miley Cyrus, James Franco, and Tracy Morgan, this cast is pretty much stacked. And from its story perspective, this movie has a pretty interesting twist on the classic story from A Christmas Carol. Mr. Green gives each of our leads a different type of weed that represents past, present, and future, and they tell us a pretty funny story by following the three independent stages that these characters fall in. This is not a forgettable movie by any means, but it's not one that tends to come up in conversation each year, so I always get excited when I remember it. That being said, there must be a reason that I don't think about it whenever I think about the Christmas season, and I definitely don't think it falls into the upper echelon of Christmas movies, so I'm giving it a solid 7 out of 10. I absolutely recommend it to any fans of the cast, and really any fan of a good holiday movie, as long as you don't mind watching Seth Rogen go on a drug-addled rant about hating his unborn baby. Now, this is the first review I've done on this channel for an older film. I intend to do a lot more of these in the future, so if you've got some movies you'd like to see me review, let me know in the comments. Thanks.